If I pray when I don't feel like praying, is it really prayer? This video answers this question. The first thing that I would say is that when you pray when you don't feel like praying, yes, it is really prayer. And in fact, that is when you really obey God and pray. Let me show you what I mean. True prayer is done with our spirits. What do I mean by that? We are tripartite beings. Each of us has a body, a spirit, and a soul. We pray with our spirits. That's why unbelievers cannot pray to God, because their spirits are dead. We who are born again, we are born again of the Spirit. Our spirits have been regenerated and we have life in our spirits, and so we can communicate with God. Remember, the scriptures say God is spirit and his worshipers must worship him in spirit and in truth. This is Jesus speaking to the woman at the well in the book of John. God is spirit. Spirit communicates with spirit. Our emotions, our feelings are part of our soul. See, the soul has the emotions and the mind. And the body is what we see physically, the flesh. And our spirit is how we communicate with God. So they are separated. So we can communicate with God by praying with our spirits. Even when we don't feel like it, they're in separate parts of our being. The next reason that I have for you is that the only prayer that God accepts is prayer that the Holy Spirit both inspires and directs our spirits to pray. See, God communicates with our spirit. When we go into our prayer closets to pray, we need to have no confidence on the flesh. Have no confidence in our ability to pray with our minds. We need to submit to the Holy Spirit and ask Him, Holy Spirit, please help me to be able to pray. Because the Bible says, we do not know to pray as we ought to. But the Spirit helps us in our weaknesses. And He utters groans that words cannot even express. The Spirit helps us to pray. And the Spirit knows the heart of God. And because the Spirit knows the heart of God, and our spirit knows our own heart, God's Spirit is able to help us, help our spirit pray and communicate to God. Submission is not truly submission until we submit when we don't feel like it. And God commands us to submit to Him and pray. Let me explain. Say you have a friend and you go out with your friend to go eat. Your friend wants to eat pizza and you want to eat Chinese. You hold very strongly to your opinion. You really want to eat Chinese and your friend wants to eat pizza. And after a while, you decide to go and eat what your friend wants. You decide to go and eat pizza. You give up your own desire, what you had a taste for, and you happily go to eat pizza with your friend. You love your friend. You hold no grudge against it. You just go with him and you're going to enjoy the pizza even though you didn't feel like it. When you do that, you've submitted your desire to the desire of your friend. But suppose that on another day, you wanted to eat Chinese and your friend was also in the mood for Chinese, and both of you go out and eat Chinese. Even though you are eating the same exact thing your friend is eating, you are not submitting to your friend's needs. Even though you are doing the same exact thing. Submission is truly submission when a person submits when they don't feel like it. Obedience to God is truly obedience when we obey God when we don't feel like it. This is very important. When we do this, we're actually submitting. When we pray because God tells us to pray, not because we feel, then we truly submit to God's authority. Jesus did not feel like going to the cross, and he calls us to a life of sacrifice. Let me show you some scriptures. Jesus said in Luke 22:42, "Father, if you are willing, take this cup from me, yet not my will, but yours be done." Jesus did not feel like going to the cross to die for you and me. And if he did not go to the cross, if his feelings won the day and Jesus did not go to the cross, you and I will be dying in our sins. Why did Jesus obey God? Because Jesus was not listening to his feelings. He was doing the will of God. As followers of Jesus, Jesus has set an example for us. And he says, don't follow your feelings. Follow the will of God. Whatever the will of God is, that's what you do. Let's read the next passage from Romans 12, verse 1 and 2. "Therefore, I urge you, brothers, in view of God's mercy, to offer your bodies as living sacrifices, holy and pleasing to God. This is your spiritual act of worship. Do not conform any longer to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you will be able to test and approve what God's will is, his good, pleasing, and perfect will." Let's look at verse 1 again. What is the Bible talking about when it says, "Therefore I urge you, brothers, in view of God's mercy"? What mercies? What mercy did God show us? The mercy he showed us at the cross. The mercy he showed us when he crucified his own son at the cross. When Jesus died for us. When he didn't feel like. Because of those mercies, in view of those mercies, in view of that, we need to offer our bodies as living sacrifices. Jesus set that example for us. Jesus was a living example. He was a living sacrifice. And we too need to become living sacrifices, holy and pleasing to God. This is our spiritual act of worship. This is just a fair thing to do. When we do verse 1, then he says, "Do not conform any longer to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind." When we let the Word of God, when we spend time in the Word of God daily, day and night, and meditate on it, we renew our mind and we are able to pray more when we study the Word of God and meditate on it. Meditation often leads to prayer. Then you will be able to test and approve what God's will is, and we'll be able to follow it like Jesus did, his good, pleasing, and perfect will. Let's look at the next passage. "If anyone would come after me, he must deny himself and take up his cross and follow me." Jesus again set an example for us. And if we are followers of Christ, we must follow the example that he set for us. A person's followers follow that person and do what he does, or do what he did in the case of Jesus. And Jesus still does things now. In fact, talking about prayer, Jesus is recorded in the Gospels over 27 times that Jesus prayed while he was on earth. And he prayed in different scenarios, in different circumstances. The Gospels are a very short record of the many times that Jesus prayed. Jesus' life was a life of prayer. And when Jesus left, he went to heaven, not to relax. Right now in heaven, Jesus' chief job is intercession for us. Jesus intercedes for us every day. He intercedes for us every day. If we are followers of Jesus, we just need to do what Jesus does, and that's prayer. The next passage, "Even so, consider yourselves to be dead to sin, but alive to God in Christ Jesus." So we are dead to sin, alive to God in Christ Jesus. And my friends, dead people don't feel. A dead man has no feelings. In regard to the things of this world, the things that cause us to stay away from God, such as our emotions that cause us not to feel like praying. We are to be dead to these things, but alive to God in Christ Jesus, and be living by the Spirit of God, by the promptings of the Spirit. The Spirit always prompts us to pray. The fifth reason that we should pray, even when we don't feel like it, and it's not hypocritical to do that, it's actually a blessing to do that, is that sacrifice is not sacrifice until it costs us something. Listen to what King David said. But the king replied to Arona, "No, I insist on paying you for it. I will not sacrifice to the Lord my God burnt offerings that cost me nothing." We are called as Christians to live a life of sacrifice, and prayer is part of that life of sacrifice. It's intertwined into it. There is nothing you can do for Christ, for the kingdom of God, that will glorify God, that does not involve prayer. We always want to sacrifice to God things that cost us nothing. When we pray, when we don't feel like it, we actually sacrifice. We pray out of sacrifice. We sacrifice our emotions and our feelings, and we sacrifice our flesh. We sacrifice those things that are ungodly, and we pursue God. That is of greater value. Remember the woman that gave her two coins, the only coins that she had to live on, when Jesus and his disciples were looking at how people were going and putting money into the temple coffers, and rich people were putting large sums out of their wealth. And Jesus said, "This woman, out of her need, has given more than anyone because she gave all she had to live on." That's what happens when we pray out of our need, when we pray when we don't feel like it. So you score more points when you give out of your need. When you pray when you don't feel like praying, it shows commitment, faith, and trust. And that's important to God. The final reason that I'll give you is that God is doing us a favor to ask us to pray and to command us to pray to Him, even when we don't feel like it. God is teaching us and commanding us to eat our vegetables. As children, when our parents ask us to eat our vegetables, we don't feel like eating them. We think that our parents are cruel when they ask us to eat our vegetables, but our parents only command us to eat our vegetables because it is good for us, it is good for our health, and it is good for our future. When God asks us to pray, even when we don't feel like it, prayer is a favor that God is granting to us. We're not doing Him a favor. When we remember these things, we'll be able to pray and know that our God who loves us is going to bless us. Remember, I shared with you Jesus when He cried to the Father that, "Take this cup away from me, yet not my will, but your will be done." He didn't feel like going to die on the cross for us, but He did, because it was God's will. What was the reward? The Bible says that because of what Jesus did, God raised Him and gave Him a name that is greater than any other name, that at the mention of the name of Jesus, every knee must bow, both in heaven and on the earth. That because of the sacrifice that Jesus did, because it was the will of God, even though He did not feel like it, God has given Him an eternal priesthood of the order of Melchizedek. God has made Him a king forever, and God has put all authority into His hands. When we obey God and do what God asks us to do in praying to Him, even when we don't feel like it, we should remember that God is doing that out of love for us, because He has a reward for us.